Catholic Church claims it provided $28 million worth of in-kind compensation to residential school survivors, but has repeatedly refused to say what that meant. CBC News has obtained an internal list of those Catholic claims. It includes support for drop-in centers or Indigenous student scholarships. But there are also millions in spending for things like sending nuns and priests to northern communities or for Bible study groups. One academic says the church was focused on converting Indigenous people to Catholicism, not helping survivors to heal. In 2005, the church made three key promises to survivors, totaling $79 million. But new documents obtained show that those promises were watered down. And in a separate court case last week in Saskatchewan, the CBC and the Globe and Mail succeeded in obtaining other files detailing the Catholic Church's two other promises to survivors. It promised to give its best efforts to fundraise $25 million, and less than $4 million was raised. It also promised $29 million in cash, but also came up short after spending millions on lawyers and administration. $2.7 million for lawyers for unrelated work, $2.3 million allocated for administrative costs, $1.8 million loaned to the fundraising campaign, and $8.4 million deducted for amounts paid to survivors before this agreement. One survivor says that's not nearly enough, considering the magnitude of the damage and the church's failure to keep its promises. AJ Felix has waited years for answers from the Catholic Church.
The truth is starting to come out. The truth is finally starting to come out. If it took money to destroy us, to destroy our way of life, it's going to take money for us to rebuild what we lost.
Felix says he's glad this is all coming out. He says the church betrayed survivors.
Because of the misery that we had, the hardships that we had, the violence that we experienced, and the sadness, and the deaths, the suicides that we went through, the alcoholism that we went through, somebody has to be accountable.
Felix is skeptical. He wonders if this will be just one more broken promise. For AJ Felix, he says it's clear the church is still hiding the truth from survivors. And without the truth, he says there can be no reconciliation. The lawyer for these Catholic entities said no one was available for an interview. But in an email, he said that all of these in-kind services were approved by an independent committee. The church promised a best effort to fundraise $25 million. In total, less than $4 million was raised. It also promised to pay $29 million to survivors, but wasn't required to follow through. Finally, it promised $25 million worth of in-kind compensation, meant to be direct, practical support for survivors. Some was delivered in the form of addictions treatment or scholarships, but the church also included its expenses in conducting Bible study groups or sending priests and nuns to remote communities.
It does appear to be some, well, to put it politely, some creative accounting. More importantly, not to fulfill the purpose and intent of the residential school settlement.
In Manitoba, a Catholic priest has been banned from preaching and teaching publicly after accusing residential school survivors of lying about the abuse they faced. The statements were made at a Winnipeg church over weeks of services which were streamed online. Fill-in priest Father Réal Fauré told parishioners that survivors lied about sexual abuse to get more money from settlements and joked about shooting protesters who defaced churches. The Archdiocese has issued an apology, disavowing the comments completely.
The majority of residential schools were run by the Catholic Church, but it's the only one where top officials haven't apologized for its role. And today, experts say some Catholic organizations are obstructing efforts to find unmarked burials and identify children by withholding thousands of historical records.
First Nations leaders hope an investigation will now be launched.
Obviously, you know, we hope that there is some type of investigation, and right away. Do it now. Like, don't wait 6 months and trying to find every excuse in a book to delay or prolong an investigation.
There is a responsibility that lies squarely on the shoulders of the Council of Bishops of Canada.
Some feel it should rest even higher. One of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission's calls to action, a papal apology never offered.